It is now my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Morris Carter, director of the Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum, Fenway Court, Boston.
It was a wise provision of Mrs. Gardner's will that no work of art should be added to or removed from her collection.
So about the time that he begins putting the duct tape on, he says, this is a robbery.
I mean, to trash a museum like that, it was just like the barbarians had been through. I mean, to pull frames off the wall and shatter the glass.
They spent 81 minutes in the museum, which is an inordinately long time for a theft of anything, never mind art. There's absolutely no question they knew the police weren't coming.
The artwork involved was from Rembrandt, it was from Vermeer.
It is the holy grail of art theft, 500 million euros worth of paintings.
When I broke all the glass and everything in there, I felt real bad about that.
You know, I was like Tony Soprano. I had all the gourmands, I had the money, the cars, the nice clothes. In my neighborhood, I was a star.
Two guys go in, they get 200-300 million in paintings, nobody gets hurt. What's better than that?
It's been more than 28 years since 13 artworks stolen from Boston's Isabella Stewart Gardner Museum were last seen.
Nearly $500 million worth of art gone.
Since then, not one arrest, not one credible proof of life.
With a $10 million reward now on the line, how can that be?
When the FBI says, we solved it, we know who did it, it's like, no, you don't, because you don't have the paintings.
The authorities that are on this case are the wrong authorities. And so therefore, you're not going to get any paintings back.
I'm Kelly Horan.
And I'm Jack Rodolico.
This is Last Seen, the definitive story of the world's most spectacular unsolved art heist.
From WBUR in Boston and the Boston Globe.
The story of one of the world's most unusual museums.
A splendid fairy palace where anyone can go, all built about a courtyard where lovely flowers grow.
And one of history's most confounding crimes.
This case is like the perfect storm for someone like me, for it to like ruin your life. Because I know that if I go to my grave unsuccessful, that I'll go to my grave an unhappy person.
When no one can be trusted.
How can you find the truth?
He had asked me several times if I would be his alibi. And at the very end, the last time I saw him, he confessed to me that he had done it.
Last Seen, starting Monday.
Subscribe on Apple Podcasts or wherever you get your podcasts.